Your systems, where are you going to place your athletes? I believe some systems are better than others, and that's your job. gets killed, she gets blocked once, and instantly she looks at me and says, is it okay? I said, and so the goal was for her to hit the ball, and I just gave her the freedom to fail. It's okay to make mistakes. And then training, how are you teaching? Are you following the laws of learning? I'm not going to get into that, but as coaches, I break the laws of learning all the time. And they justify it. It only makes it a little easier. Well, you know what? They're not having success, so let's block the score for 60 minutes. We need to play the game, and we need to get really, really good at teaching cues within the game. And when you do that, you might not see success right away. In fact, it will be ugly. Really, really ugly. But I promise you, if you continue to do it, your team will also be better at the very end of the game. If you want to check out the webpage, the guy's name is Trevor Regan. It's called trainonly.com. I brought him in to speak to my girls for the entire week at the beginning of the season. And the guy was awesome. He created a mindset of learning, of not caring, that you're trying to look good rather than be good. And in order to get better, the first thing that I want to talk to you about in point story. So I've been doing this, I tried to pick the three areas, attacking, blocking, and serving. They are not ranked by importance. That's just the only way you can score points in our game, unless you're going to get by making mistakes. So I narrowed it, I'm going to talk about those three points. So we'll go for that. The first area isn't exactly like that, but I score points every match by doing this. And it's being a non-anxious presence to my team. Where they have the freedom when they're not playing well, but they come to the sidelines and get beat up. Do they get frustrated? Do they get all tight? So I get anxious. We ask our players to play with full motion. You need to play your role. You've got to play with passion. You've got to have the hope of the future. You have to play this moment. But we as coaches break this all the time. We decide that, you know that, what will happen?
And then I'm creating a The fact is that I like the word smooth, I like the word simple.
things that I'm doing. And so, in order to jump high and hit harder, I have to do certain things that need to be in place. So I'm going to go over a little bit of techniques. I'm going to talk about range. I'm going to talk about different plays that you can run. I'm going to talk a little bit about gaps, a little bit of transition movement, speed, strength. We'll see if we get into all these things. I'm going to use this run lady who's the best outside hitter I've personally ever coached. And I believe mechanically, she's spot on with the best international athletes that I've seen. So, I have to jump higher and I have to hit harder. So I make sure They have nothing to do with each other. It's all about timing and reach. Sophie's arm is drawn back, the lower shoulder, and she's going to get at the top of her reach by actually just reaching. And so my challenge to you is, can we get them to draw here? Her shoulder, in 5 years, she has never gone to therapy once that I know of. The kid can swing all day long. These are another thing, she can do another thing, but her shoulder can seems to go forever. Just a little bit longer. And so it's just healthy, it's strong, and it's moving in a way that really helps her. I find your final category of body seems to work really well at angles. We have a little bit more power here than we do here. If you look at pictures, when they come around, they're up in this position. So if we can get into a bit of that reach position where our body's starting to shift, we're going to do really well. But you drop this one here. Okay, this is deep corner. This is one of the top big fours. Can they hit those deep corners? It's really, really hard to defend that. So this deep corner is typically open. We're going to see players standing there, and if you're going to hit a shot, but that's the spot that you need to have on your bucket list. Landing, I would encourage you for as much as possible to land closer to 2 feet. A lot of times when you come through, I like to say you want to open the door and then you want to slam it shut. And you're using your hips to slam this door shut in order to generate power, in order to get your body and everything free so you can do it. And if you do that, often you won't land perfectly like this, but it'll be a nice left foot or right left hand for a different attack. But landing, okay, here's another shot by Sophie. Cross court. She's going to have this shot, but she's going to beat the block if you give her that to get back to her. Here's a wrist away shot that she's got. And then the guys are a little bit more efficient with this than girls are, but it's basically dropping your thumb. The best to do is just drop your thumb in order to do this and get that ball. And you can do it the other way. You can drop a pinky if you want to go back the other way. So she's going to drop her thumb here, and she's going to put it pretty sharp. She's good at seeing seams. If you give her a little bit of the seam, then this is important. Can you create seams for your athletes? Or maybe seam the block. Once they start seeing the block, they're going to find what's available to them. Okay, here's an inside ball. Slightly inside, create a little bit of trouble. It's a 33 ball. This is a recycle. We've been working really hard at that. When we don't get the ball, I'm a selfish coach. I know that we typically only score points when we have the ball. So I want to keep it as much as I can. If we don't have a good set, so Nikki, my setter, is in a tough scenario here. She sets the ball a little bit inside. So Sophie just kind of hits it left into the block, hoping something good will happen. Something good does happen. She gets recycled. We cover it. She transitions. She's a good transition move. She's not doing this. She's turning. She's running. She's getting back. So she can get a good circle of the ball. And now she has a better system set that's a little bit more of a system. And that's the end of the game. Off the hands and open the finger. Heaven off speed. I've worked really hard to find an off speed shot with her. She doesn't off speed enough. We're working on that earlier. And I believe as an attacker, we need to have range. We need to be able to put it in different places or different spots on the court to challenge your athlete because we're going to play different systems. The first thing in scoring points that I can spin it in. And that's one of the key words that I use at all levels. You guys, spin the ball. Girls, spin the ball. And often, I always thought for years we had the contact here. We had to know that in order to create topspin, or ask your hand comes underneath, and it creates this motion like this. Because I don't actually get a lot of topspin if I just go on top, because there's nothing really to generate the spin. So if you want to hit the corner, if you want to hit the edge of the court, which I believe is the most important, you actually have to spin it there. And the more we can get our kids,
something like